We welcome you back. You know, as parents, we are the biggest cheerleaders for our children. We want them to do their best and feel good about it. But as they head back to school, there are some things parents should think about. It might not always be the best idea to heap praise upon them at every turn. Dr. Rachel Glick is a licensed counselor here to talk about it. You wrote a blog about it. Wait a minute, we're not supposed to be champions for our children, doctor?
Well, of course we're going to be champions.
Of course we are.
Yes, but it's the how we do it and how often we do it. And there's a lot more awareness now for how we can praise that really helps build true self-esteem and helps kids take more risks and be more growth-oriented.
So there are people who say, sure, praise your children, hooray, hooray. But then they're all going, no, let them learn on their own. Kids are too soft these days. You have two sides of the fence here.
Absolutely. And a lot of couples get into conflicts over it too with their kids. So one of the things that's really important is not to overpraise and make it very general and blanket statements about their innate ability. There's a lot of fascinating research that when we praise effort, that they've made a lot of effort, that actually encourages them to want to put more effort in going forward.
So it's not necessarily the end game. I know you tried really hard, but you guys didn't win the game.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
But it's good to measure, it's good to compliment the effort and the resiliency and things like values and traits and process versus just the win.
What type of lasting effect does praise or lack thereof from parents have on kids?
Well, I definitely see it a lot as adults, that if it's overpraising, then you can become dependent on approval seeking and keeping up an image, versus praise that's balanced really helps you to feel motivated to go to the next step in your own life and to take risks. And so when we don't praise enough, though, and especially when praise is tied to love, like if kids think that they're loved based on their performance, it really messes up their sense of self-worth.
Yeah. Well, let's give some examples. If a child made an error that cost them the game, what should we say?
Well, first it's important to get a feel for how they feel. Ask them questions.
Yeah.
Help them process their feelings about it, and then encourage, it becomes a teaching opportunity to encourage that this is part of the process of life. It is sometimes the strength you find when you feel like you have failed that really makes the difference in adulthood.
What about if they won first place in the science fair?
Well, you definitely want to be excited for them, but you want to not saying that even shifting from I'm proud of you to you must be really proud of yourself or I'm proud for you.
You allow them to take ownership of their efforts.
Exactly.
Right, right.
Exactly.
This is really interesting as kids go back to school because we hear about the everybody gets a trophy and my kid is best and all this.
Yes.
So this might be a really good refresher course for
Absolutely.
Parents. Right?
Yeah.
So you need to read this blog, moms and dads, especially as your kids are heading back to school. We've got a link to the blog for you as well as Dr. Rachel's website. It's on our website as well as our Fox 2 mobile app. It is some interesting reading and definitely will make you think as a mom and a dad. Thanks for coming
in. My pleasure.
John, I know you're going to do your very best to read this tease.
Thank you, Randy. That really inspires me.
Uh-huh.